Each police department has to figure out how to keep these protests peaceful while letting voices be heard. In Norfolk, they've chosen to support protesters with police escorts. And as my co-anchor Anita Blanton explains, a listening ear.
Yeah, Tom, Chief Larry Boone says that he and the department have really tried hard over the last 4 years to build up some trust in the community they serve. He admits now they have to hit the reset button to heal this deep divide. But over the weekend, he decided to be the change he wishes to see and show his commitment face to face.
His name,
George Floyd!
Saturday, this crowd's journey through Norfolk had an unexpected twist. Yes, there was the sadness of the moment that another black man's life had been reduced to a hashtag, the anger and frustration from making this walk before. But then, this exchange.
Let me get up to the front. Y'all got to go.
I got caught up by multiple questions, and I tried to field as many questions as I could. I might have answered 30, 40 questions.
Unbeknownst to them, Chief Larry Boone was nearby but unseen for an hour as more people joined. The riot team was ready, but he said no. He didn't want that to be the narrative here.
It had been nonviolent. There hadn't been any damage, and, you know, they were a model for the world to see.
Peaceful, albeit understandably disturbed.
They are expressing their grievances, and their grievances are real. They're very emotional. And these are real times, times that I hadn't seen in 30 years.
These are people in pain, wondering if Rodney King's fight preceded Eric Gardner's pleas for air, and it still led us to hearing George Floyd beg.
You see a man being killed for public consumption, for the whole world to see. And it pained me to think that some loved one would see that. It pained me to see that you saw life leave his body as he cried out for his mother.
Will his last breath finally be the catalyst for change? Boone says yes.
We need to have real progress. And I have no doubt after this, because I've never seen anything like this, there will be real police reform.
Now, Chief Boone says that he fully expects there will be more protests in the days to come until, at the very least, all of those officers in Minnesota are arrested and charged. But he says the challenge moving forward for all departments will be encouraging the good officers, weeding out the bad ones, and then the challenge of recruiting the very best people possible at a time like this when it's so critical to have the right people in place. Anita Blanton, 10 on your side.